here anymore. Who even are you?
Never mind who I am! Just get back in your time machine, get back to the present, and stay there!
No, Gupadina! No, Gupadina! No, Gupadina!
You gonna flap your lips? Are you gonna do what I said?
Can't believe I got scammed for the baby tickets. I wasn't expecting to see an actual baby. Maybe I should teleport back home. Why does it smell like doo-doo in here? You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna get out of here.
Stay there!
You missed.
Loser!
You have failed her, Mr. Chicken Jeff Weenie. You shot the don't shoot this button. Now get ready to watch a poorly edited iMovie video.
Rally Kids Cigarettes is about to bring you the Baby Boomer Nuclear Family. This is Daddy Peter, breadwinner and head of household. Sue is the name of his wife, and here are his perfect children. This is Kevin, the firstborn son. And this is little Bill. Oh boy, he's a handful. Daughter. And of course, Brian the dog.
We don't trust just any cigarette for our children. Raleigh Kids is the only cigarette made for tiny hands. It's why it's the playground favorite, right, kids?
Baby boomers are defined as people born from 1946 to 1964 during the post-World War II baby boom. According to Howe, baby boomers were prophets, which is why they feared change. Baby boomers were idealistic and driven to change while maintaining traditions. And as you can see, the nuclear family keeps on going. These roles are given and they will carelessly stay the same. The boomers got to see the moon landing. This is because technological incentive was at an all-time high. As a result, the boomers faced an economic boom.
Hi, I'm Peter. This is Lois. My son Stewie and Chris. Our dog Brian and the rest is this. Live in Quahog near the beach. A wizard gave my baby the power of speech. No one can hear him, but when he's away, people in town can hear what he says. This is Family Guy.
Ronald Reagan. He was always fun, especially in his later years.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall. Tear it down. Reagan smash. Reagan smash.
What's that?
Oh, it's just Reagan. Just leave him alone. He'll tire himself out.
Excuse me, Mr. Cobain? Look, I know you're depressed. Made some bad choices with women. But there's another way. Haagen-Dazs. Lots of Haagen-Dazs. Well, let's see if it worked. Here we go. Ha! Still a...
Is anyone else fed up with this oversaturation of music? Three channels and they're playing the same song.
I hate that my parents are getting a divorce.
Don't you guys love to hang out without supervision?
Hey, you guys! Cleveland, be quiet. We're reading magazines.
Hey, did you guys hear what happened to Kurt Cobain?
Yeah, I read about that. It's pretty crazy that he would take his own life. Cleveland, please stop. Nobody wants to think about Kurt Cobain right now. Just leave.
Oh! My name is Peter Griffin, and I'm a bad friend who doesn't care about his other friends, and I sound really stupid. What did you just say about me, man?
Margaret Thatcher.
Generation X were sometimes called the latchkey generation. Due to little to no adult supervision compared to previous generations, this was a result of high divorce rates and increased maternal participation in the workplace. People also refer to Gen X as the MTV generation, sometimes being characterized as slackers, cynical, and disaffected. Generation X were not only consumers of punk, but also the creators of it. Generation X is known to be the Reagan era, voted by the boomer generation. This is also a post-civil rights generation. Back then, you'd be criticized more more harshly for having friends like Cleveland.
Everyone, sales are down across the board, but mostly we're failing to connect with a group called millennials.
I saw this guy cry one time.
To learn more about our target demographic, we're all going to watch this instructional video.
Millennials, also known as Generation Y, are known as the hero generation and are optimistic, confident, and resilient. Who are they and what do they want? A millennial is born between 1982 to 2004. Millennials are considered the hero generation, meaning that they were born during the time of weak institutions and distrust in the government. A generation that grows up as increasingly protected children. Millennials crave things like instant gratification, authentic experiences, and for some reason, improv comedy. This generation is generally marked by usage and familiarity with the internet, mobile devices, and social media. In the West, they're likely to be less traditional and religious than their predecessors. Millennial men dress in metrosexual fashion. It's okay to wear a man bun, kids. This millennial also has a parakeet with 1 billion followers on Snapchat. Millennials are skilled networkers and are aware of their civic duty to let everyone know their trigger warnings. Here's another millennial that started the hashtag that canceled 12 network TV shows she found offensive. And now I'm being told she identifies as a man, so I'm being fired. And now you see a fresh contact. These millennials vary in worldview. Whether you're a xeno-Marxist, post-colonial, post-modernist, post-left-radical, eco-anarchist feminist, or a simple guy who likes hot dogs, your experiences in society define your worldview. Thanks. The end.
So please welcome someone who's going to help us reach millennials, our new head of social media, Hammer.
Oh, he just group texted us hello. And now here comes a text from the guy who doesn't know this is a group text. Nice to meet you, Hammer. Let's have lunch later and I'll tell you who's gay.
Right on. Sup, I'm Hammer. First, I'd like to not thank you for hiring me because I just expect good things to happen to me without working for them. Second, I'd like to give you all a list of my trigger warnings.
What's a trigger warning?
Actually, bruh, asking me what a trigger warning is one of my triggers, bruh. I feel traumatized, bruh. And now I'm tweeting about you, bruh. And now you're trending, bruh. And now your life is ruined, bruh. And now you're fired, bruh.
What? What happened to bruh?
Also, the lack of diversity here is horrifying, bruh.
Bruh's gone.
Now, if we want to get some social media attention, we gotta start with a group selfie.
Excuse me, didn't Ellen do this like 3 years ago?
Hey, does Tay Diggs follow you on Twitter?
No, but Kraft Singles does.
That's what I thought. And posted. Do you know what I just did? I just made you all viral. Also, my band is playing tonight at an inconvenient time. It's six unshowered guys and a pale woman with a ukulele shouting hey in unison. Because that's what music is now.
Hey! Hey!
What is this? They just keep saying hey.
I know, it's my favorite song.
Oh, cause hay is for horses.
Hey guys, you want to have a smoke break?
What? We can't smoke inside.
It's not smoking, Peter. It's vaping. Everyone's doing it. Come on, Peter, give it a shot.
What happened? All of a sudden, I feel like I know better than everyone else.
That's because anytime someone walks through a cloud of vape smoke, a millennial is born. Peter, you're officially a millennial.
Hey, you want to ride in the Millennial Falcon?
Ah, look at that, we found another one.
Peter, a rite of passage for any millennial is attending Coachella. It's a great place to see bands that are either really new or really old.
Which one should we see?
Well, on the main stage, it's Tame Impala that formed in an Uber pool on the way here. And on the side stage, it's Neil Young asleep in front of the television.
I always get him confused with Bloom County's Bill the Cat.
Peter, you're doing great as a millennial. Next thing is you gotta learn how to be on fleek.
On fleek? People still say on fleek?
No, Peter, that's not what I meant. I want you on fleek. This is fleek.
Oh, can I ride him?
Sure, Peter. Get on fleek.
Yay! countries involved in 6 different wars, but millennials think about this stuff.
Well, I'll see y'all tomorrow.
Nice work, Fry. Whoops. Well, at least Joe gets to be a cyborg.
Gen Z, the generation of snowflakes, always on the move for a social movement. A guy like me has to fight for what's right. After all, Pat is a hero. I hate this generation, with their need to cancel people for saying something taken out of context, their massive egos thinking they're going to save the planet just because they were predicted to do so. The supposed artists of the century, but all their art is boring and always has to have some sort of unknown meaning. Heavily influencing the next generation through fresh contact could be a bad idea with all their hate-filled political views and worldviews.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Why are you so upset about Pat?
Pawtucket Pat was a phony!
I remember you. But no, he isn't. He's a hero.
Not anymore. He's a racist murderer, and this statue should be torn down.
God, there's a lot wrong with this, but you can't tear this down. Pat's an icon. That statue belongs right here in the park, next to the statue of Quahog's greatest missionary, Father Touchboys.
That statue was removed a year ago.
For what?
Better get a tweet out for all my gorgeous babies. About to see the new Safe Space movie instead of The Lighthouse starring Mr. Weening. Hashtag I'm gangster. Wow, I haven't seen that many sweaty, muscular men since I worked at McDonald's. Hashtag thinking in tweets.
No.
Hey, are you at Dog Killer from Twitter?
I am. Are you a fan?
You ugly jerk. You have no taste in movies.
What the heckers was that? Uh-oh. Wow. You are blowing up bad. Oh, look at that. At Wayne Chicken just picked it up. Buckle up, buddy.
There he is!
Where? I'm in the back!
Weren't you thinking writing that tweet?
What? It was just a joke.
Brian, it's not 2005. You can't just go online and have bad movie taste.
Alright, I'll delete the tweet. You haven't deleted it yet?
Yeah.
What a train wreck. There, done. See? It's done. It's gone.
But what about all those people outside?
Don't worry, they will see that I deleted the tweet and this will all blow over.
I hope so, but you never know. They're still pretty mad at me down at Dick's Sporting Goods.
Your dog wrote an insensitive tweet. You can't eat here.
Uh-oh, Meg. It's a sensitivity mob.
It was just a joke. There's no such thing as jokes anymore.
Yeah, we live in a post-joke world.
Chris, maybe we should just eat outside?
No, Meg, we're eating here.
I'd like to see you try.